YouTube. This is the Father's Day edition. Right here, I'm using a no guard, the level open, giving my father a fade. Now, he has, you know, that salt and pepper hair, so, you know, you got a lot of gray hairs, a lot of black hairs. I'm just going to try to even it out and make it look good for him, you know? That first guideline, I'm just using the level open just because sometimes when you're cutting, like, gray hairs, it's like, it'll actually look like there's no hair there because the hair is so light that there's actually hair there, so you got to kind of, you know, keep going over it. But that's why I'm using the no guard with the level open just to get it, you know, even. So it's like a little bit of a stubble there. So it's not bald, just a little bit of stubble. You know, same thing in the back. I'm using these wall magic clips. Like right now, these are like my favorite clippers right here. I love the way these clippers cut, you know. I got to give me another pair though. Just to have two on deck. Make sure you make that line even, that first ball line. Just make it even all the way around. You don't want it to be lopsided, because then the fade will be lopsided, you know? Right here is the one guard open. Make the second guideline. And then this one, you're not going to really see a lot of hair coming off, because he already has like kind of like a one on the top. Pretty much this was from the last haircut he had. So it's pretty much like a one on the top. So he's not going to see a lot of hair coming off with this one guard open. Keep going over, you know, the same spot to make sure you cut as much hair as possible in that spot so that everything is even. And one thing about like gray hair, for some reason, it's like real stubborn. Like you got to go over it like four times sometimes just to cut like that one strand. It's crazy. All right, y'all, you see that dark spot right there where my thumb is at? That's a mole in my pop's head. So don't think it's like a dark hair patch. That's a mole. Same thing in the back. Just keep going over the spot just to, you know, get the hair even on that guideline. Keep brushing too. Make sure you get all of the hair that you done cut off of the head. Because sometimes if the hair sticks to the head, like you'll keep trying to go over it, and it's actually already here that's cut. So make sure you brush over the spot that you put the clip over, and then go at it again. And this is the half guard close. Yeah, I'm just trying to take out that bottom line right there. So you just kind of hit that line at the bottom, and it'll slowly start to fade out. Make sure you keep brushing after you put the clipper over the hair, just to get all of the cut hairs off. You know, make sure you brush it again. See that line slowly coming out. I don't know if you see this line right here, this line I'm trying to get out. Like, as you see my pop's head, like, he got like like two or three waves. I think he 360 G's or something, but that line in his head is from the way he wear his do-rag, so it's like a dark line that goes like around to the back. I've been trying to hit that spot for a minute, and it seems like it's taking a long time to come out. This is the one guard close, just trying to blend that top part in. Brush work going, man. see them little bit of waves that's right there where the clip is at now. It's like 3 or 4 of them. I counted them. My pops is crazy, yo. So he better get his wave game up, man. He can't be slacking on the wave game, man. These waves out here, they'll shut you down in a heartbeat. Better stop playing with it. It's like a lifestyle for them, man. You don't be play waving, you feel me? You see that one wave right there at the back. Trying to knock that out. Just to get it to blend better. Right now it's just a little bit of cleanup work. This is the half guard. I think this is closed. Just trying to, you know, get some of those dark spots out. The reason why you see me pausing for a while, because like I'm, you know, stepping back, looking at it. Because like I said, with the gray hair, sometimes you can't even see it. So it'll look like there's no hair there, but there's a bunch of hair there. So that's why you'll see me pausing for like, you know, a couple of seconds just to kind of step back, look at it at a different angle, just to try to see if there's actually hair there. But this is just, you know, just a little bit of cleanup work, just to try to get rid of some of those dark spots. Also has wrinkles in his head. So yeah, he got a funny head, man. You'll see some other things on the front of his drink. Ooh. Yeah, that spot right there. You see that gash, that light spot right there? Yeah, that's a no-go right there, but there's nothing we can do about it. Pops was telling me a story about how he got that. He said some guy slapped his sister, and his sister came upstairs to get him. And he went downstairs, start putting hands and feet on the dude. I think the guy pushed him or something like that, and he fell into a car. And that's how he got that gash in his head at the top. So, you know what I mean? There's nothing we could do about it. I mean, I probably could have took the head down, but he wanted like the number one on the top. But if I took it down to maybe like a half guard or something like that, it probably would, you know, look a lot better. So he said, yeah, I ain't with it. So I left it. This is just, you know, lining them up. That shit look bad, I ain't even gonna lie.
Oh, hell no!
Oh, man. Yeah, I was tripping, yeah. I don't know what happened right there. I think I looked at the camera, and then when I, you know, put the clipper to his head, it was wrong. So, yeah, I was tripping right there. I was bugging. But we back at it. These are the wall detailers. These cut pretty good. I like the feel of them. They're pretty sharp too. You know, everybody, you know, uses Andis all the time, but you know, these wall detailers, these are pretty good. These and the wall heroes, they're a smaller clipper, but they're real powerful. But these detailers, they cut pretty good though. See those hairs, those gray hairs right there? It's like I went over them like 3 times, and the joints wouldn't even move. So I had to go over them again and brush them and go over them again. But gray hairs, they're real stubborn. Right, I'm just trying to fade the beard down a little bit. It's the first time me like fading a beard, so I mean, I'm just doing like, you know, trial and error, seeing what works, seeing what's not cutting. But it's the first time me trying to fade a beard down like this. I'm just trying to blend it to the front of his beard, to where his chin is. Fighting with them. They can slowly come off though. We just gotta keep going over. Just a little bit of laser work to try to sharpen up the line a little bit. I already put the 245 shave gel on it. I didn't put a lot, so I mean it's just like a real light layer where his hairline is. So that's why you don't see it as much, but you can see a little bit of it. My pop said he really do like the smell of the 245. He said it smells pretty good. So that's what's up. Shout out to Chris Bazio once again. Everybody's liking this 245, man. Keep the movement going, man. Salute, bro. Sharp. The bed line always gotta be sharp, man. That's what makes the bed pop, that sharp line.